बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर आईटी टीचर शाहिद अली खान एंड टुडे वी हैव अनदर न्यू वीडियो रिलेटेड टू ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड इट्स टाइप। सो वन बाय वन वी विल सी ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम टाइप्स। लेट्स सी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। An operating system, in its most general sense, is software that allows a user to run other applications on a computing device. While it is possible for a software application to interface directly with hardware, the vast majority of application software are written for an particular operating system. OS is short for operating system. So operating systems are used to make possible that the person or the user can communicate with the computer, or it interact with the user and the computer, in simple words. So operating system is a system software, and that is essential for the computer if we want to perform any task through the computer. So operating systems are the essential system software. We can see operating system in this diagram. There is a main backbone job performed by the operating system. We can see in the central there is operating system, and it is responsible to communicate or to control all these devices as well as application software. We can see operating system is communicating with the different application software. We have lot of application software we have installed in our computer if we are using Windows operating system, or if we are using Android operating system in our mobile phone or tablet. So we are using different apps, different application that is compatible with Android operating system, and other hardware devices are also controlled by the operating system. We can see monitor, keyboard and mouse, and any other input output device, for example microphone, scanner, and the printer is also output device, and the operating system is also communicating with the printer, that is hardware device. And HD is hard drive or the hard disk or the storage device. So in this diagram we can see that operating system is responsible to control these all input output devices as well as different apps or application. Single user operating system. A single user operating system is a type. In the background we can see the main is operating system, and operating system further have two categories. Number one is single user and the other one is multi user. A single user operating system is a type of system that has been developed and designed to on a computer. It can be used on a similar device and it only has one user at a time. In single user operating system, a single user can work at a time and there is no facility of any other communication with other devices and or computer. Single task operating system, it is also called single task operating system, can function on electronic devices like computer and will run only application at a time. And it can run only one application at a time. So this one is a single user operating system. We can see in this diagram a person is working on the desktop computer that is IBM compatible and using Windows operating system, and that one is using Apple Macintosh operating system that is compatible for Apple computers, and this user is using on different Android base or Windows base or different operating system using in different gadgets or different devices. So say this diagram is explaining about the single user operating system. Now move towards the multi user operating system. A multi user operating system is a computer system that allows multiple users that are on different computers. For example, different users are on different places or different cities or different branches of the company or different branches of the banks. So they can communicate easily by using multi-user operating system. access a single system operating system resource simultaneously. Most batch processing system for mainframe computer may also be considered multi-user. In mainframe computer, we have discussed about the mainframe computer in different classes. The mainframe computer have a huge capacity of processing capacity as well as storage capacity, and it supports a multi-user operating system. At the same time, thousands of users are using different apps and different softwares, so they are using mainframe computer. And multi-user, multinational companies, banks, they use mainframe computer for a centralized computer. So mainframe computer use multi-user operating system. As we have seen, consider multi-user to avoid leaving the CPU idle, because CPU is a fast processing device that can perform billions of instructions in a second or microseconds. So if you do not have tasks, so computer will go to the goes to the ideal condition. So avoid for the ideal condition, we have provided different inputs or different tasks. Operating system, multi-user operating system, we can see are different terminals. We have seen in the central, there is a multi-user operating system and terminal 1, terminal 2 and terminal 3. Different terminal means different computers, they are communicating with the centralized multi-user operating system. Another diagram of a multi-user operating system, we can see there are different users and they have connected with the same server or main server. So for networking purpose, we use multi-user operating system. In this diagram, we can see a different user, user 1, user 2, 3, 4 and 5, and they are using different apps, different programs. In the last, we have diagram, we can see there is a comparison between the single user and multi-user, and there are different names of commonly used single user operating system and multi-user. We can see portable digital assistant, a pocket PC or a tablet. Right now we are using a tablet or a mobile phone, so they are using single user operating system or single task operating system. They are also called single task. We have explained about the MS-DOS. The MS-DOS is a CLI, command line interface. We have to put the command, then the computer will return the output. So this is called MS-DOS. This one is also a single user. And multi-user, we have Windows, list of a Windows family. And they have capability of multi-user operating. So Windows 2000, Windows Server 2003, Windows Server and so on. Macintosh operating system is also a multitasking system or multi-user operating system, and the Linux is also multi-user operating system. I hope, students, you have understood about the operating system definition and operating system task, that how operating system is important for the computer. And after that, we have discussed about the different types of operating system, single user and multi-user. They are also called single task or multitask operating system. I hope that you have understood, or if you have any questions, so you can mention in the comment box or you can ask. In the next coming video, we will discuss with a new topic. So until that, Allah Hafiz. I'm going to signing out.